have taken one vertex, one edge from where the light is passing. So the above 4 points is what I'll consider for which projection would be falling onto the ground. Let's name them A, B, C. The fourth one won't be of any relevance. So ground I'll name 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so let's take one by one. So, you know, this diagonal I have taken as the reference for the ground. Okay, so from the bulb, you take one line that goes through point A and it goes straight ahead somewhere, I don't know where it will be falling onto the ground. From B, one more ray of light. So, I'll make a straight line just from the bulb from A to somewhere infinity. Then from C also have to take the same thing. Okay, so guys, now let us see. You know, just below A is 1. So where will the ray of light from A go? Just below, perpendicularly below. Okay, so I'll take one line from the reference to 1 to straight, and this is the point where the ray will lie. B, straight niche 2. Okay, take a straight line from 2. It will meet the ray here. Similarly, below C is 3. Just perpendicularly below. All the ray of light passing through C would be from 3. You'll take the reference from 3. So the shadow is 1, 2, 3. And the 3 points. So this is the shadow that is casted onto the ground. So this is the shadow that we'll see. There'll be also a shadow that is beneath this cube, and there's also a core shadow that is onto this cube as well. Okay, so this is the shadow. So guys, I'll also tell you one more trick. You know, just like this one, I'll tell you one more trick. Here we took references from below and then above line to check where the ray of light would fall on the ground. So I'll tell you one more.